So you have been a vegetarian since when again?
July of 2020.
Okay. And what was the inspiration?
There, I watched a few documentaries and read a few books that all kind of indicated to a happier, healthier your lifestyle that happens when you only eat plants, because the foods are better for you and you also get away from the guilt of eating animals and other stuff like that.
Was it hard to do? Because how old are you?
I'm 20 now.
20. Was it hard to give up?
It was. I was actually, prior to my change, I was the biggest meat eater of all my friends.
Really?
Yeah, like no one thought I would be able to do it. I had only said I'm going to do this for a month.
Uh-huh.
But I got 2 weeks in, and then I'm a big runner, so I ran my best time I had ever ran for a 5K after 2 weeks of eating vegetarian, and I was like, man, I'm never going back.
Wow. So you ran your best because your body, your cellularly, you were healthier?
Yeah.
And you could see the big difference.
The difference was immediate. It was...
Wow.
I went from a 25-minute 3 miles to a 21-minute.
Wow. Is anyone else in your family vegetarian?
I turned my mom vegetarian.
You did? That. Right, you're right. Because you told me that she had gotten ill.
Yeah.
And so did that help with her health?
Yeah, she actually has lost over 110 pounds.
Wow. You know what? Do you incorporate fasting too?
I don't love fasting, but I know the science behind it, and I appreciate its like value. It definitely is there for people,
uh-huh.
But as a 20-year-old who works out a lot, I'm not.
Yeah, it's not the best thing to do.
Yeah.
Okay, because I know a lady, what just made me think about it, is a lady was diagnosed with two forms of cancer and given just a short amount of time to live, and she changed her diet.
Right.
And then she fasted. So she took some things out of her diet. She wrote a book about it.
Really?
So I'm going to be interviewing her on that. That's what made me think about that. I'll just look forward. Is that?
That's really cool.
This one right up here. So yeah. I'm interviewing Zack. He's an Illinois State University student majoring in
dietetics
and a minor in Spanish. His desire is to help people change their diet so they can live healthier lives and have dignity of days and live longer. So while we're walking, picking up trash in this community project, we talked about the value of when you volunteer, you meet people and you learn things from them. And even if you come by yourself, you meet somebody along the way. So I figured I'm not gonna wait until he starts his webpage, his YouTube, to share this information. But I'm going to do that now. Okay, so tell me more about what you've learned in terms of whether it's diet and health and why this has increased your passion. Like you said, your mother was an impetus of that because she had gotten ill, and you helped turn things around with changing her diet. So what else?
What else? So I guess for me, my whole life has been like sports, actually, like stuff like that. But around high school, I started plateauing out in terms of like being able to compete with other kids as much. And I was wondering what I could do that would be able to help change me too. And what I realized is I kind of needed to overhaul my whole life, because I realized in high school and stuff like that, I played baseball, and on my baseball team, it was not the greatest for kids. And I wasn't around the greatest influences and stuff like that. But then once I changed, once COVID hit and everything was, you're given a lot of free times and kind of a new start to do things, I wanted to live a more meaningful life and provide value to others through.
So you were having some vices that you decided that's not good for my health, is that what you're saying?
Yeah, basically.
Okay. And so at a young age, I mean, really early, because sometimes people struggle with vices and doing things a lot longer than 20, but at 20, you came to some actualization that, hey, let me rethink what I'm doing with my body.
Right.
And so that's when you decided with that you were going to major in
dietetics.
Okay, you see, I don't know what that is. Is there a lot of, I remember we did something in home ec, that's all I know. And
yeah,
and we did everything, but it wasn't, you know, it did this and that, but it was not all focused on dietary issues or diet content. Why do you think it's so important?
Especially in the United States. I mean, we have the most available food supply in the country, but we lead the world in,
We've seen snakes and bunnies while we're cleaning the streets on up.
Yeah, I'd be careful.
The west side, I'm not going to come in here because we've already seen a snake. So.
What was your question you had asked? I think it's so important because we have the most available food sources, but at the same time, we have the most people in a nation that have diet-related illnesses, whether it's type 2 diabetes or heart disease, which is the leading cause of death in the United States, and what's really fascinating about food and stuff like that is if you eat there's study after study that show eating mostly plant-based can actually reverse a lot of heart disease. There have been people who needed triple bypasses who were like, all right, this is scheduled 6 weeks out from now. If I eat healthy like that, can I avoid this? And that's happened countless times.
Wow, you know, I was just listening to it came out on the news the other day that studies show that avoiding red meat reduces the chance of, you know, heart disease.
Yeah.
And normally we wouldn't like to communicate that because you don't want to mess with the meat industry because, you know, but when it's so conclusive, and like you said, with the statistics we have, it's time. Like, I'm picking up this little cigarette package here, and they tried to not say that could affect lungs. So, but I'm glad that we still get some good news that tells the truth and gives people an opportunity to have information to want to change the case. Yeah, instead of saying, oh, that's okay, and work against their health because somewhere somebody says that's okay because they don't want to lose money. But we have government agencies that hold, you know, like the health and cigarette companies accountable. And now, despite, you know, our love for meat in America, the news media admits and shares this. I don't know what it's going to do to us and to the meat industry, but if we live longer, yeah.
Truly, there's so many benefits that people think about. So like you talked about cigarette butts. Uh-huh. Red meat also has a lot of the same carcinogens that exist in cigarettes and stuff like that. People don't
really.
You don't think of food.
I never knew that.
You don't think of food as carcinogenic.
No, you don't. Yeah.
It's fascinating to learn about. I don't know enough about that topic to speak very in-depth about it.
But you've heard, some connections with the things that they're putting in the processing of meat.
Right.
That it has had the same effect that smoking cigarettes with the additions and stuff like that.
Yeah.
That's somebody's picture I'm picking up. The child. I feel bad about it, but it's in the garbage and it's wet and dirty.
I also like, in terms,
there's a bag over there.
I'm a big sustainability guy, hence coming out here trying to pick up trash.
Uh-huh.
Stuff. And what I really enjoy about eating plant-based is so even for fake meats that are made, you know, like the fake burgers, fake whatever, fake sausages,
mm-hmm.
those consume like 90% less resources to produce that product than it does for like a burger. A burger uses some, I don't know the amount of gallons of water, but you'd be shocked to know how many there are used to grow just one burger.
Wow. So in terms of sustainability, there's less trash that we get from consuming plant-based as opposed to consuming meat because everything that goes into processing and packaging has lower sustainability.
And like, so right now we have more cows on the planet. More cows on the planet than have ever existed, right? And cows are actually a big producer of methane, the greenhouse gas, because after they eat, what they have to they regurgitate their food to digest. And when they like burp, they release methane gas in the air, which with cows, it wouldn't be a problem, except for we've industrialized the cow industry, and now we have billions of cows existing.
And we've also put chemicals to make them so they're not as healthy, too, because they've been
so
fed
true.
To get big, and then wonder why children each year are getting bigger and bigger, because of the hormones and the stuff that has been put into those animals.
Interesting point of the food industry too, by talking about hormones and stuff like that, because it's pretty fascinating to learn that we are actually building up some people build up a tolerance to certain medications and other things, not because they're taking it, but because our animals and stock are fed so many different antibiotics to get them to the right condition to feed.
So is that a good thing or a bad thing?
That is a bad thing, because the reason so many antibiotics are having to be utilized is because
naturally being produced in our bodies anymore.
Right. And
our immune system.
And they're not healthily taken care of like the chickens. Like if you go to a chicken place, it's not chickens roaming around the grass eating natural things like you'd want. It's them all stuffed into a room on top of each other, not even touching the floor.
Oh, God.
So
I didn't know that.
Yeah. That was a big advocate of life. Just look up factory farming and see the videos that exist. It's pretty terrifying.
There's just probably
stuff.
Maggots in there too, disease ridden. Yeah,
it's
horrifying. Just wash it out and sell it, and put some chemical in it to make it look pink. Oh, excuse us. Okay, so again, I'm talking to Zack, and we're on a cleaning expedition, volunteering to clean the neighborhoods on the west side of Bloomington. He's an Illinois State student. I'm at District 87. I'm substitute teacher, but mostly I am a writer and got a YouTube page, Pam Grace. So he's going to be doing something, providing resources of the information he shared with me, because like I did not know a lot of things he shared with me, you know. So it's been quite an education, and I appreciate it, because the more you learn, the more wellness you have for your brain. You know, you learn something new every time I build new, dendrites, whatever, in the brain. Is that what it is? So they're being fired up. And I'm being guilted too, into changing my diet. Now, I'm not gonna tell you my age while we're on tape, but I'll tell you later and why that's so important. I'll tell you some things that in my family that we can do better with by changing our diets. And my brother, he's done that. He's let go of a lot of things when he had a heart attack.
Wow.
Not, sometime back, and then he just recently, 2 years ago, he had a stroke. So he changed his diet. He's eating a lot more plant-based food, taking out a lot of the salts and sugars and stuff like that. So I do appreciate that. And he's lost a lot of weight.
Yeah.
So your mom lost about 100. I think my brother's probably close to that.
Yeah, my mom went from 260 to about 155 right now.
So then the inside of her body cleanses itself out too, huh?
Yeah.
Cellularly. I don't know, can you quantify your body cleaning itself out, other than the fact that you said you ran longer, people sleep better, you can see they lost weight. But is it a way to say...
for sure. There's a lot of biomarkers that would be able to tell you how your body changes. So I'm also an exercise science major,
okay,
which is where this stuff comes into play. So once you eat healthier, you work out, train, all that kind of, all the good health stuff that you know you should be doing for yourself, you will, there's numbers as in like your red blood cell count will go up. Your hemoglobin, which is part of the red blood cells, will go up along with that. You will have, if you did a blood test at a dietetics office, there's a bunch of different numbers that show your levels of the vitamins and minerals. So like your vitamin B's, yeah, your vitamin A, your vitamin C.
And you're gonna be, I think I know this. You're gonna be more efficient at processing and holding on to it.
Yeah.
Because your body is clean now, and it says, okay, yeah, we handle this.
Right.
And it can be excreted through the intestines, because the intestinal wall is clearer, because I don't have red meat in it.
Yeah.
Do I sound like I know something?
Yeah.
Oh, right. Okay. I learned a little thing.
It's plaque. When heart attacks happen, because too much plaque builds up in the blood can't get to the heart anymore, and then you have a heart attack. So
is it just the diet? Isn't it, or is it like with the chicken before the egg before the chicken? Stress. It's stress because of the diet, or diet because of the stress?
I one thing that I've heard a lot, which I wholeheartedly agree with, is people say like your relationship with food is often a direct reflection of your relationship with life at the moment. Like if you're feeling good about life and you're doing things that make you happy, make you feel fulfilled, you're more inclined to want to eat healthier for yourself and do things right. Whereas if you're feeling bad in a depressed state, it's very easy to just...
Oh, okay. So this is, here's a Christian thing who says, the love of the Lord thy God with all the heart, the soul, the strength, and the might. And to love God with our strength is to realize that I am the temple, the Bible tells me.